My name's Tara Gunlack, and I've been skating since I was 7 and I'm 19 years old. I first put skates on when I was 18 months old. I'm now 19. I have two sisters that skate, so that's how I got into it. I remember when I was 3, there's a video of me skating around, falling over, getting back up and just kept going. I now work full-time as an apprentice hairdresser. So I used to train 5 days a week, but now I only train about 1 or 2, which does make it a little bit harder. Most thing that I enjoy about skating is just that it's different. No one believes what you do. Everyone's like, oh my God, wow, that's so good. It's just amazing to know that there's so many different people out there who have no idea what I do and enjoy every minute of watching it. I recently, this year, went to the National Championships in July. They were held in Sydney and Liverpool. To be able to get selected for the World Championships, you have to compete at a national level, place first or second. I placed second out of 8 and then was selected to go to the World Championships. I then went to the World Championships in September, the end of September, beginning of October, and I placed 14th out of 22, which was an amazing effort, as I didn't even think I would actually get selected for the World Championships. I've been all over Adelaide, Australia, interstate, Perth, Sydney, Melbourne, Queensland, for all the national championships. We go to Melbourne every year for their state championships, but I've extended my travelling as well. I went to Germany in 2009 for my first world championships. When I was 15, I went to Taiwan for 2 weeks to train over there with my coach. We were training 10-hour days for 2 weeks and would only have an hour lunch break. I got to meet so many amazing people everywhere I travel. You just get to mix with all the different countries, Italy, America, everywhere. Everyone is so nice, and all they want to do, they're all there for the same reason that you are. I would absolutely love for my sport to be in the Olympics. We are currently about 4 countries short. With working full-time, I now coach as well. So I fit in coaching 1 day a week. I have a little skater who's about 10. She's so beautiful. She loves the sport as much as I do. She's always smiling, always excited to see me. And that's how I encourage more people to just come and skate. It's so much fun. It's so different. And the smile on their faces when they achieve something and have so many role models like myself, who they want to be like, is just so exciting, and I just love it. I do go ice skating sometimes with the group. I have thought about doing ice skating. My dad always said, oh, you should do ice skating instead. We'll go to the Olympics then. But honestly, the love that I have for this sport will never change, and I could never move to ice skating. There's just something different about roller skating. No one knows what it is. Everyone is actually scared to give it a go, but if you just relax when you fall, it doesn't hurt. These days, the sport is self-funded. It always has been self-funded, so we have to come up with the money ourselves to be able to go to the World Championships, and most of the time you're looking between $2,000 and $5,000 to be able to just go. I would not be able to do it without my parents. My parents have supported me since I was 7 when I first started competing, and they just keep always wanting to push us forward and always making sure that it's exactly what we want to do, never pushing us into doing anything that we don't want to do. They always support me. My mum and dad came with me to New Zealand, and it's the first World Championships my dad's been to in so long, so it was the best feeling to have them both there, to be able to watch me in front of thousands of people.